All right, so hello everyone, my name is Jan. I work at Perfect Dashboard, and today I would like to show you what is website management, how and why exactly you should do it. In other words, I will show you how to greatly increase your monthly revenue and while improving Joomla's brand image at the same time. So the big question is, why should you be managing websites? Well, most of you should know how a typical project looks like. A client asks you to build a website for him. You agree on its cost, on specifications, and the time frame it should take you to complete this task. You sign a deal afterwards, or at least I really hope that you do. The website is built, and once the client stops pestering you about some last minute changes, you get paid. And typically, you forget all about the website afterwards. Unless, of course, the client will break something, then he will surely remind you about it. But the real question is, why in the world would you want to edit there? This could be a beginning of a beautiful road to lots of money and happiness. So let me tell you about the main advantages of maintenance, which we will be using to achieve the aforementioned goal. Well, first and foremost, if you have ever done website freelancing, then you must know the situation when in 1 month you have so much work piled up that you can't possibly find the time to complete all the tasks you are given. While in the other months, let's call them dry months, you have virtually no work at all and are starving for more work. Well, website maintenance will help you to remedy the latter situation by increasing your monthly revenue so that you won't have to worry about making your men's meet ever again. Besides that, your clients will thank you about the feeling of security for his websites and for his brand. And another great thing is that with the right tools, it won't take up much of your time at all. And last but not least, you will improve the Joomla's image for its potential users who are now scared to try it because of its tarnished reputation. Let us change that status quo. All right, but how exactly do you get your clients to agree to those services? Well, there are a few really compelling arguments that you can use. Over 30,000 websites are being hacked daily. Well, do you think that's a big number?
Yeah.
I think so too. I think that's a huge number. And I'm afraid it isn't going to decrease anytime soon. Well, perhaps you have heard of a recent ransomware attack. It's called WannaCry. It literally made the train stops in some countries. So your clients should know that hacking nowadays is very much a thing and is a constant threat to our own livelihood. And of course, there are a few script kiddies who are just hacking websites for fun, but most of the time, the real target of a hacker isn't the website itself, it is you, your client, or your client's clients. For example, let's say that your client is using the same password for his site that he uses for his social media accounts, for his email, and for his bank account. Surely you can see the implications of that. All right, so how exactly can you convince your existing clients? Well, we already built our websites, so we know how it is supposed to work, its design, its structure, sometimes you even know its code. So that makes your job a lot easier. Next up, continuity of service. If your client will perceive you as an expert in this field, that you know what you are doing, and you are keeping their website safe and sound, they will be more likely to ask you to perform more projects for them or for their acquaintances. Your clients should know that keeping their site up to date is the best way to prevent hacking attacks. Of course, that won't protect you against zero-day vulnerabilities. Fortunately, they are much less common type of hacks. Usually, hackers are targeting outdated versions of software using known vulnerabilities. Well, what about new clients? Well, first thing that you should explain to them, that websites aren't a billboard or a newspaper ad. They are a living organism that is constantly evolving. New features are being added, and unfortunately, new security issues are discovered over time. And clients should be aware that even if his website is fully secure right now, it is only a matter of time when, and that's a when, not an if, a new vulnerability will be discovered for it. And of course, not only website or, in our example, Joomla could be vulnerable. The language that is written in PHP has had many various security issues throughout the years. Also, the database engine like MySQL or MariaDB also has had many vulnerabilities. Software that is serving your site, Apache Nginx also, and of course, someone could get into the server itself. So in the event of hacking, clients should know that not only they are likely to lose some or all of their valuable data, if it gets out that their site was hacked, their users will have a really hard time to trust them again, which could lead to a brand destruction and reputation retarnished. Look no further than Yahoo as a prime example of that. Yahoo could be the next Google. Well, actually, they were Google before Google. But because of various hacks throughout the years, the total number of leaked data, user data, was more than the average population of a country in the world. So yeah, that's a huge number. Okay, so what exactly is maintenance? Well, there isn't really a defined rule set on which services you should be providing in maintenance. I'll try to tell you which services are profitable to you in the long run, more profitable to you in the long run than the others. So what is really scalable and won't bring you much trouble with the increasing number of sites that you manage? Well, backups, of course, they are basic basis of maintenance, are typically hassle-free. Updates, monitoring, and security measures, if done correctly. Next, what you could be doing, but you have to ask yourself a question, whether it would be really profitable for you. For example, hosting. That definitely isn't a piece of cake. You should be constantly on the top of things with it. You also wouldn't want to constantly fill in new content on your client's websites, as it is a rather boring and tedious task. And new features. Of course, that depends on the feature itself. Some of the features could take up to a few minutes, while some may take weeks or even months. Again, you would have to decide whether that will be profitable by yourself. And for example, migrating website from Joomla 1.5 to the current version 3.7.2, yeah, that is a real pain. Perhaps some of you already know that. None of the extensions or templates are backwards compatible. So basically, you have to rewrite the site all over again from scratch. Only thing you can really import these basic Joomla articles. Okay, now I want to show you how should you efficiently manage websites. The company that I work for was a web development agency and has had a lot of trouble with managing websites, and as none of the existing tools on the market were fitting our needs, we came up with our own solution. And I'll show you on our application how exactly you can save a lot of time doing that. So, first thing that you should do with the site you're managing is to thoroughly check how vulnerable it is. Usually, it is very much so. So, typical security audit should contain of checking the passwords, PHP, MySQL version, of course Joomla and the database extensions, who has the access to backend, file and folder permissions, and PHP settings. Now let me show you how it looks like in our tool. This is a demo site that I have added to our application. I'm not sure if you are seeing all of that. We are checking whether the site is blacklisted by Google Safe Browsing. We are checking the backups for malware. I'll get into that in a minute. We are checking for the firewalls, over the various PHP settings or README files or any other information that could disclose to a hacker what exactly are you running and how he could exploit it. Like, for example, template positions, whether your backups are accessible through a browser, whether there is a backup schedule, you really should keep it, and of course, whether everything is up to date. Now, back to the malware for a second. Well, you will surely experience a hacked website from time to time. So what you could do to unhack it? Well, first thing you should do is to, of course, scan the website for any malicious code. Then the optimal situation is that you download the same Joomla version from a GitHub repository and unpack it and just overwrite all the core files with it. The same you should do for all the extensions, so just uninstall and reinstall them again. Next up, you should remove the malware from miscellaneous files, especially check the images folder.
Question. Yep. What's about the custom changes in profiles?
Well, we are also detecting custom changes, so if you really shouldn't be doing custom changes in Joomla, as it will prevent you from updating it, which is really, really bad. But yeah, we're also detecting whether there are custom changes, so if you have some, you can see where exactly they are and just copy it and override it, later. And finally, once you get rid of all the malicious code, we're pretty sure that this website is squeaky clean, you should change all the password, privileges, and database prefixes to prevent another attack. Now let's talk about backups. When you should be doing backups? Of course, before starting work, in the event that something goes wrong. Afterwards, after your work is done, of course. And do not use what we are calling it Schrödinger's backup, that you don't really know whether you have a backup that you can restore unless you actually try to restore it.
Yeah.
Next up, set up an automatic schedule. It should be set up as frequently as possible. And you really shouldn't keep your backup on the same server that your website is, for a number of reasons. Namely, if your website will get hacked, then most likely the backup will get corrupted too. Also, if something will happen to a server, your backup will be gone with it. And I will just show you a quick example of what we are doing with backups. We make backup of your site. We then send it to we are creating a remote server, especially for this purpose, where we send your backup there. Then we check. We compare the checksums of all the files from the live site with the checksum of the files from the backup, so we will be sure that everything is actually restorable. Then we're checking all the files for a malicious code, looking for custom changes, and you can choose where to send the backup afterwards. All right, so let's get down to the nitty-gritty, to the updates. Well, the typical scenario is that you see that the update is available for your site. So you better make backup before the updating in case anything goes wrong. And as some of you may already know, many things could go wrong with the extensions or even Joomla update. It could break your site. So after the update is done, you really should visit the front end of your site and click on all the subpages to make sure that they are indeed working as they should. Well, and if you have a lot of subpages, then you probably just random clicking on a few of them and cross your fingers and hope that everything is fine. Well, what if I could tell you that we could automate that process, do that for you, and do that more thoroughly? Let me show you how we are doing that. Before the update, we are making a backup, and at the same time, we are making screenshots of every subpage of your site. Then we perform the update itself. After the update is done, we are again making screenshots of your whole site, and we are comparing the results. So let's click here. Okay, something seems to be wrong. And you can see the screenshots of Joomla before the update. You can see that there is it is not scrolling through this. Okay, so here is a Joomla 347, I think, and the newest 372. And you can see on the comparison screen that something has changed. Maybe I'll show you a better screenshot. Okay, so you can see that we before the update, we have the input with a newsletter or something at the top. After the update, the input is gone. So you can see on the different screenshot that something went wrong. Yep.
How about if your website is 50 gigabytes in size? Our
servers contains about 30 gigs. So yeah, if you have such a big website like 50 gigs, then I kind of think that something may be wrong with it, that you can optimize it in some way. Anyway, you can use our testing engine for even 100 gigs website. You won't just be able to use our backup tool. Okay, so let's talk about securing the website. Some of you may know that most of the scripts that are attacking Joomla are targeting the administrator folder. The simplest way to prevent that is to use HTTP-based authentication. This is called a secondary login for a folder. I'm sure that most of you have already seen it thousands of times. So the basic command for that is to use htpassword that will generate a file when you should input your password. You can encrypt it in MD5. I know that's not really an encryption, but yeah. And optionally, you can deny the access to the folder from all the IPs except your clients and of course yours, but that will only work if your IP and your client's IP are a static IP, which unfortunately isn't always the case. Another thing that you can do is to add an additional parameter to administrator folder. For example, your website.com administrator question mark and your secret parameter. If someone wants to tell you, want to input this parameter, you'll just be redirected to the front page. Those two extensions, and I'm sure many others can provide those options, JSecret Authentication and Admin Tools Pro. Next up, that one is quite obvious, firewall. Those are the top, one of the top extensions from Joomla Extension Directory. They mostly have good reviews. I'm sure most of you already know them. But the disadvantage of a client-side firewall is that it is also an extension, so someone could get access into it. Well, there was a famous case for WordPress. One of its biggest firewalls, called WordFence, has had a security issues in itself, which hackers used to get access to the site that they were supposed to protect. An additional or alternative solution is to use a server-side firewall. We are just redirecting your DNS address to the addresses of service that is providing this. And not only are they filtering all the traffic that comes to your site, it also, most of them, I think all of them here, are also providing content delivery network and caching. So it will not only secure your website, it will also make it faster. Next step that you should do is to remove everything that isn't absolutely necessary. Like I said before, all the extensions can have various security issues in themselves. So if you are not using something, then you should just remove it from the site. The same goes for templates and, of course, unnecessary users and administrators. And let's say, for example, that your clients will want to put some new content on your site. Well, then besides administrator account, you should create for him an editor account, so which he should use to put the new content there. Also remove the backups, like I said earlier, and remove other sites, other versions, and development stages. Now let's talk about a main security issue, namely passwords. Of course, passwords should be hard to guess. You can use some password manager like LastPass, KeePass, or 1Password to generate you a big random hash of various letters, numbers, and other characters. However, you can also consider that a really complicated password you have to store somewhere. Alternatively, recent studies show that a good alternative option is to create a long string of random words that you were actually able to remember. For example, I don't know, sun, desk, wall, Joomla, anything you want. And of course, you should keep different passwords for everything and limit the number of people with access. And to summarize, we have learned what management is, what are its advantages, how to get clients to agree for those services, and we have seen a practical way of doing that. Now, let's think about what we can do to change Joomla's reputation in the eyes of its clients. Well, by keeping their sites well maintained and safe, we can make Joomla a synonym for security. And for all you attendees, we have created a special coupon code which will give you 15 euros of credit so you can test our features some more. It's, you just put the JAB17 in a credit section of our site.
What's the cost for your service?
Well, we are giving a few credits for free to everyone. Then the cost of management is three euros for each site.
Monthly.
Yep. Or annually, when will you switch to annually, you get a 10% discount. Okay. Any questions? Yep.
What would you say your main advantage against watchfully?
Well, watchfully has very similar options, but they do not have automatic testing, visual testing like we are doing.
Okay. Do you also have an automatic campaign with all the websites inside?
Well, we are not a fan of automatic updates because we are working on staging, we should enable that, but if you do not have staging, well, we will automatically update website for you, and it will break, then you see the issue here. But we are working on implementing staging, so that also be resolved by that.
You talk about protecting the administrator site. But you don't mention about the two-factor authentication, because it's already
Also,
there is a reason for this or not?
Yeah, two-factor authentication is a very good option too. Joomla has by default Google Authenticator and YubiKey. So if you are a fan of one of those solutions, you can run them out of the box. Okay, so, yep.
You said something about protecting the administrator folder.
Yep.
But if your client wants to change something, you have to remake a new folder. You go to editing folder.
If clients want to access something, you can just give him the access or the secure key, so he will be able to access the administrator normally.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I didn't understand.
Okay. Anyone else? Yep.
What are the options for external backups?
For the moment, you will either get them by email or you can use our cloud or you can use Amazon S3. But we are working on Google Drive and Dropbox integration, which will come really soon.
So this is only for Joomla?
No, it's for every CMS that is. We are only providing updates functionality for Joomla and WordPress, but you can add any CMS or any site at all to our application. Okay.
For free.
Yep.
Okay. Nice.
All right, so thank you very much.